Some members of the community and Ohana Ho'opakele organization haven't given up on a pu'uhonua, instead of a prison, on the site of the reinstated Kulani Correctional Facility. The advocates for the Hawaiian cultural wellness and healing concept have been speaking up as Senate Bill 3119 makes its way through the state legislature. The measure will appropriate more than $20 million in funding to make the return of Kulani Correctional Facility a reality after it was abruptly closed in 2009. So far, that funding does not appear to include a pu'uhonua. Jim Albertini, who's been getting the word out on the bill and inspiring a flood of testimony in support of the pu'uhonua, has been speaking out as a member of Ohana Ho'opakele for years on the issue.
Pu'uhonua is really a solution to the problem of prison, which keeps getting worse and worse. The state keeps locking up more and more, especially Hawaiians, and it's doing more damage instead of helping the community and helping people and their families.
Ohana Ho'opakele has been working, I think, now for about 14 years with a dream of getting a pu'uhonua for our pāhao. And so we've been focusing on Kulani. Instead of them bringing it back as a minimum security prison, we think that they are obligated to find a solution, and the solution should be a pu'uhonua, what the Hawaiians were doing a long time ago.
I noticed at the first meeting I went to back in the beginning of the year how even though Ohana Ho'opakele was mentioned, it seemed like they were being ignored in it, and it kind of upset me, so I got on board then.
Ohana Ho'opakele has filed a lawsuit challenging the state's final environmental assessment on the reactivation of the Kulani Correctional Facility, saying the state should have looked into having a pu'uhonua at the site as mandated by the state legislature.